Hello guys, welcome to my channel. In this video, we will go through the basics of video editing in Filmora so that you can also edit your videos easily. So without further ado, let's get started. So first of all, open up your Filmora. And select new project. Alright guys, so Filmora is open now. As you can see, the screen is divided into a few parts. The bottom part here is the timeline part, the timeline area. This here, the black box, is the preview area. This area is the project files area. All the files that you import are gonna be shown here. And this on top is the menu bar, okay? So first of all, let's import a few videos. I have downloaded some free stock footages here. So to import your video, you can drag and drop your video like this. Just check yes, or you can just right click here, click import, and just go to the location where you have downloaded your files like this. Okay, now as you can see, we have imported our project files here, but the timeline area is still empty. Okay, so to populate this, we are going to be dragging the video that we want onto the timeline. Is gonna give us a prompt that do you want to match the media with the project. That means the dimension of the project of your video file is going to be set as default of your Azure project setting. Let's click on match to media. What this does is that if your video is 4K, then your project is going to be 4K. So as you can see, the preview is showing here on the right hand side. You can see, okay, you can click on play and it will play here. It's pretty simple. Okay, now let's go through a few editing features here on this editing bar. Okay, so the first one is undo, then redo, then it's a delete, and then we have a split. What split option does is if you want to cut the video, suppose you want to cut the video from here, then what you have to do is you just place your seeker just where you want to split the video from and just click on split. See, what this does is split the video into two parts. Now I can delete the rest of the video here by clicking and deleting. See, it's pretty simple. Now what I want is I want to add another footage right after this. So what I'm going to do is I'm gonna click and drag the board footage here and just add it to the timeline. Let's try and play. Pretty simple, right? Okay, so as you can see, the top right, the top bar is showing us some numbers where our seek is right now. It's currently on 16th second, on 21st second. So to increase and decrease the size of the timeline, we just click and drag on the time ruler. Okay, it will increase and decrease the size of your footage. It will help in precision editing of your videos. Okay. Now let's see what more options we have. The next option is the crop option. What the crop option does is, when you select a video and click on the crop option, it will give you an option to crop certain part of your video from it, from your video. It will give you the option to crop some part of from your video. Like if I drag and drop, drag this area here, only this rectangle area will show in my video. But as you can see, the dimension is also changing. Okay. Now the next part is the speed. In Filmora, you can increase or decrease the size, the speed of your video. Let me just delete the board video here and just show you. As you can see, currently the waterfall video is 30 seconds. Now what I'm going to do is, I'm going to click on this video, go to the speed option, and slow it by, say, increase the speed by 2x. Now, as you can see, the video has been sped up. Okay. Now, similarly, I'm going to control Z. Now, similarly, I can decrease the size, speed, by 0.5, and it will increase the length of the, increase the duration of the video, and the video will be slowed down. It's pretty easy. Let's do control Z. Let's see the rest of the option. We have our advanced color tuning option. It will help you to adjust color of your footage. We have a temperature option. We can set the tone of the video as warm or cool as we want. Let's saturate it a bit, increase the vibrance a bit, and decrease the brightness a little. In this option, you can color correct your videos like this. Actually, that's too much blue. What I'm going to do is, I'm just simply going to boost the saturation. There we go. Increase the vibrance a bit. There we go. It's looking nice. Okay. The next option here is the green screen option. It will help you adjust the chroma key option if you have a chroma key video with you, which you don't right now. So let's control Z. The next option is the edit option. It actually shows the transform properties of the video. We can rotate this video, scale it. Okay, but we don't need it right now. You can do it in your videos. Okay, so all the top bars are clear. Now let's add our board footage. And see what kind of footage this video has. We have open sea. The sea is nice. Let's start the video from here. Remember, guys, click on the video and use the split option to split the video into two, and then delete the previous part. Now, as you can see, I have deleted the video that was before it. So there is a gap here. We can easily cover the gap by clicking on the gap and delete that. And this way, the video is seamlessly transitioned. Okay. Awesome. Now let's color correct this scene as well. Actually, let's cut the video first. I want to cut the video right here. Let's split it and delete it. Okay, let's color tune it. I'm gonna do the same routine, increase the saturation, vibrance a bit, a lot, and okay. Nice. Let's use another footage. I have a drone footage here, drone 4K. See, I'm gonna cut this video from here. Place your seeker where you want to cut it and then split. Nice. Let's color correct this drone sequence as well. Okay. All right, guys. All right, guys. So that was the basics of how to cut and join your videos into a montage. Now let's do some effects. Okay, so right now we have three different types of footages: the waterfall, the open sea, and the lighthouse. So what I want is a sort of 3D transition in between. So lucky for us, Filmora has a lot of pre-built transition options, transitions and effects and titles and a lot. That's why I always use Filmora. So to use the pre-made transition, we're gonna go to the top bar here. We have our media, audio, titles and transition. Let's click on transition. And here you can see we have a lot of options here. We have our basic, 3D, ripple dissolve, speed blur, and etc. So let's preview a few. Let's try some basic first. I'm gonna click on my bar option and just play here. It's just a preview, guys. We still haven't applied it. So just click and play. These all look a bit cheesy, actually. We don't need this. We have a page girl here. This is looking nice. Let's try something in 3D. Let's do the orb. It's too fast. You can actually adjust the speed and velocity of all these transitions. I'm gonna go with the speed blur. Let's try this one. No, that's too odd, too obvious. Let's go with the warp. How about this? No, we have a morph. Let's try this morph. Morph is looking nice. So, after you have selected a transition, just drag and drop the transition in the middle of the two footages and just drag and drop it. Let's try and play. Nice, right? Okay. Let's do the same with this one. Let's try something a bit different. Let's try this fuzzy zoom. Drag and drop in the middle and play. Now that's too obvious. Let's to remove any transition that you don't want, just click on that transition and not the video and just delete. I'm going to do a world. Let's try this one. Too much. Let's change the category. Yes. Let's click on, let's select erase and try. This is nice. Right? Okay, so actually I'm gonna change this transition to and see how it looks. There is a problem here. The transition is taking too long. Let's edit this transition a bit shorter. Let's try. Yeah, this is nice. Let's see. Okay, so guys, now we can use the split option to split the video into, but sometimes we need a bit more of a precision cutting. So to do that, I'm just gonna, so to do a bit more of a precision cutting, you just select the video and just drag from where you don't want the footage to be. So I'm just gonna click and drag to my left to shorten the video. There we go. Okay, now let's add the transition. You see, beautiful, right? Let's change this transition to, I used a clockwise here, let's use an anti-clockwise on the other one. Let's play. There we go. There we go. This is nice. So that was the transitions option. You can just play around with those, with these, all these options. So we have a 3D ripple, speed blur, and etc. Now let's jump on to some audio. As you can see, below every video there is a wavelength here, which means these footages have audio, but this third one doesn't have any length, any wavelength. So that means it has no audio. So what I'm going to do is, what I need is, I'm not going to use any of this audio of these videos. I'm gonna put my own music in this. So we have our few audio editing options. So to edit, to increase the volume of the audio, we just double click on the footage and go to the audio option, and here we have a few settings. We can decrease the pitch here on the left. You can see the wavelength is going up and down. We can increase the audio sound here. We have a fade in and fade out option. We have an equalizer, and we can change the pitch as well. The remove background noise doesn't work so well in Filmora, so just refrain from using it. Okay, so what I need is, I'm just gonna right click and detach audio. What this does is, it just splits the audio and video into two different files. Now I'm just going to click on the audio and delete. Same with this one, right click, detach audio, just delete. And this one as well, just to be safe, delete. Okay, now we don't have any audio here. Now what we are going to do is, I'm gonna unmute. And now the Filmora has a lot of audio free audios as well. So go to the audio tab and just select any of the following. I'm just gonna use Young and Bright here and click anyone, feet on board, and just let's play. Actually, no, the feet on water is going to be more suited here. Perfect. So, to add audio into your footage, you just drag and drop into the audio slot on the second option here. Now, as you can see, the audio has been placed, but the audio is way too long. So, we're going to just click and drag to my left to adjust the audio. Now, the audio and video are the same length. Let's try and play. As you must have noticed that the audio cuts abruptly because we don't have enough footage after this. So to fix this, I'm just gonna double click on the audio and just fade it out a bit. Just select the slider and you will see that a little black area is going to be filled here. That means the music will start to fade from here and it will fade to none till here. Let's try and play. Perfect. Let's drag it along, drag it out a bit. Play. Okay. Perfect. Now, I just used an audio from the Filmora library. If you want, you can also use your own audio, like I'm going to do right now. Just import the audio, same as your video option, and just use it, drag and drop. Right now I have a video with audio here. It's a cyberpunk type music, but I'm going to be needing only the audio of this video. So what I'm going to do is just going to click and drag and drop onto the top of my original video composition. What this will do is going to be is Filmora will add a second video track here. As you can see, these are all numbered 1 and 2. So on the second track, we have our cyberpunk music, and I'm gonna right click and detach my audio and just delete the video. There we have it. My cyberpunk music has been cut. Let's mute the feet on water music and try to play. This does not suit this video. So the beat of the cyberpunk music drops here, right here. So what I'm going to do is I'm gonna use the same routine, click on the audio option and split and just delete. Sometimes the blank area deleting doesn't work, so what you have to do is drag and drop. Drag. Let's try and see where the beat drops. Yeah. there is a calm music in this cyberpunk theme. Some calm part. The calm part starts from here. That's how you add your own audio. I'm just gonna delete this cyberpunk because it does not suit it. Let's unmute our original feet on water, and it's looking fine. It's looking really, really fine. Okay. Let's save the project. Okay. So you have created your video, you have added your audio and transitions. You have color corrected it and everything is almost done. Now what you want is you want to add your own titles, subtitles and etc. Basically your own identity. So to do that, Filmora has gifted us with a few titles option. So let's check them out. Go to the titles option here and just click on opener. Click on anyone to preview. There are a few options here you can try. This is nice. So I'm gonna use this one. So I want to put this one, this opener, in the beginning of my video. So to do that, I will just select all the video and audio files of my composition and just drag it out a bit, give it a little space, and then drag the opener, the video option. There we have it. I actually want it on top of my video. Let's try this. Let's try this. Click on the opener and just drag and drop. Let's play. Let's add this one. Let's select all of my footages and just drag and drop, drag away from the beginning of the video and just drag and drop the opener. Now as you can see, the opener is only a few seconds long, so I'm just gonna click and adjust the middle portion. Now let's change the title here. Let's double click on the opener, and as you can see, you can change your title here. Let's add calm. Let's do the same editing in this one as well, American Captain. I don't think it took that. Yeah, now it's done. Okay, let's try and play. You can add your name and your identity here. Let's try and change the... Yeah, this is fine. It's looking nice. Now, we should just drag the audio too. Because this is looking like... Yeah, now it's fine. Okay. So, So that was our intro. Now we can add an outro as well. Let's go to titles. So let's go with an opener as well. Drag and drop this one. Let's say thanks for watching! An exclamation mark. Save it. Now, you may have seen that in some videos people add their Instagram handles and social media handles on the videos. So to do that, people use this lower third options. So I'm gonna put my Instagram handle. Still leave this open. Instagram handle right here at the beginning of the video. Let's go to a lower third and drag and drop any of the lower third options. Let's use this one. A little funky. Okay. Let's change it. Follow me. Please. LOL. Okay. Let's change the text size. Text design. Nice. Now, sometimes people put this twice or thrice in their videos. So you don't have to create it every time. You can just select that object, Control C to copy it, and place your seeker where you want to paste, and just Control V. Okay, sorry. You also have to select this video track on which track you want to paste. And just Control V. There we have it. I'm gonna put one on the bolt one and one on the drone. Okay. Let's change the quotation here. Character Gene. That's my Instagram handle. Change the font actually, it's looking odd. Now, let's change the text color. There's a lot of control here, guys. You can just change a lot of things here. There we have it. Let's delete this one and just copy this one and paste it. Simple, right? It's fairly simple. Filmora is really, really easy. Now let's check out this effects part. Effects is a collection of video effects here in Filmora. Like, let's take this Fox film, for example. These are sort of like filters, but we don't need this because we have already color corrected our video. Let's use this flushed option here and use it on a different video track and just drag it out. That means this effect is going to be applied on all of the timeline. Let's try and play. You can already see the difference here. There's a lot of other video options you can use. Let's equalize. It also boosts your color along with the contrast and all. It does not look good. Anyway, you can use this in your videos. I'm not gonna use it. Maybe I'll just use a bokeh blur. Sorry. These are not available right now. We have a black and white option. Nice. Okay. So those are the effects that you want to use, that you could use in your video options. Let's go to the elements tab. We have a few things that we can use here. These are all transparent and you can use them on your videos. Okay. So that's it, guys. That's it for the editing part. I'm not gonna bore you anymore. Let's export this video actually. Show you the basics of exporting. First of all, save your video and click on export. Gives out an prompt, don't worry, no problem. Now, let's select our folder where you want to export it. I'm gonna save it in the desktop. Name our video, my video, let's name it travel. Go to the settings option. You see the resolution is already set as your first video, the 4K footage of the waterfall. Now I'm just gonna go to the settings option, and because I'm using all good quality videos, I'm gonna change the quality to best, and I'm going to increase the bitrate to 8000, and the encoder is H.264. It's fine. Okay, and just click on export. Wait for it to export. You can see a little preview here. Filmora takes very little time to export all, to render all this. It's actually not rendering. It's actually just compositing the footages. Completed. Let's find the target and it's 63 MB. No problem. Let's play it. Looking nice. Lower third is okay. The color pricing is looking nice. That's it, guys. Those are some rudimentary basic video editing skills in Filmora. You can use them in your own tutorial videos and etc. Just use everything Filmora has given you and just go crazy, guys. Thanks for watching and thanks for listening. Please subscribe if you haven't, and I'll see you in the next video. Thanks, guys.